Shady Grove. It's good to see each one of you here. I'd like to certainly welcome Shannon and his wife Casey here with us today. We're honored to have y'all with us.
Yeah.
And welcome. We got a couple announcements. Church camp will be next weekend. And saying that, we will have no Sunday school next Sunday. We'll all be coming back, trying to make it here for the 11 o'clock service. So no Sunday school next Sunday. Y'all got anything to add to that, or we got emails coming?
I think there'll be some emails coming. I think everything's falling into place as the Lord would have it fall into place. And so just be much in prayer for it. As always, you know, invite friends and you know what I mean. Just looking for a good time with the Lord, fellowship together, learn more about Him, and just love one another. Just good. Have a good time. So just be in prayer for it as we teachers. For our pastor, ask the Lord to oversee it all, it'll be good.
Amen. Thank you, Chris. Thank y'all for doing this. We don't usually drop into this. Is something very important in, that's coming up in our school system. They're having a meeting this Wednesday or this Tuesday at 6 p.m. at the Board of Education building. They're giving everybody a chance to stand up and stand against anti-American curriculum. So if anybody feels led in that, this is very important. It's sad that we've got to this point. And again, we don't get into politics. I know a church, but this is very important. Everybody feels led, that'll be in the, I believe it's in building room. It's in the Board of Education building, it'll be room 112. I think that's on the first floor, but I'm sure just follow the crowd. Going in. So they're trying to pack that thing out, and I believe there'll be no problem in that. So Keith, if you can't, certainly remember that in prayer. Nothing else? Any of our groups got anything? Prayer requests? Remember all those that are battling? Bill and Joanne, Larry, so many of them that aren't still able to come to church with us. Any of you remember them?
Daisy and Mary.
I don't
know if the church is having credit for a good friend of mine. Remember
that? I'd like to announce there is a Rodney Casterberry is battling COVID right now in the hospital. He is supposed to be ordained next Sunday, so I'll be much in prayer for that. I'm not sure if ordained as a deacon, but I'm sure there'll be news coming on that. Birthdays, nobody was born this week. And is any birthdays I've missed? It was a very popular week to get married, I guess. No anniversaries either. So any anniversaries I've missed, anybody?
It's too hot.
No, it's too hot. All right, I'll turn it back over to Russell. Thank y'all. Chris?
Turn to 156. While Chris is coming, we'll go on and stand. We're going to take up our offering this morning and go to our pastor. Before we do that, we'll go to the Lord in prayer. I'd like to ask Andrew if he would lead us in prayer.
Dear gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to be out in the house of the Lord today. Lord God, we just ask you to do with all those prayer requests, Lord Father, those spoken and unspoken. And just ask you to bless us going forth this week, Lord Father, and this service as well. Lord, you just give us the strength to go forth and let your light shine bright, Lord, so that we may be a beacon. Lord God, we just ask all these things in your sweet and holy humble name.
Tomorrow, my trials here.
turn to page 178.
Yeah. page 341.
And good life, and that their children might grow up in a community that's safe, and that his people will do good, not only financially, but most importantly, spiritually. And to see his people be fed and eat from God's table, and to hear the good testimonies of his people, and talk about how good God is, how to feed a man's soul. More than all the love offers this world could have. To hear people talk about the goodness of God, that is what's important, I believe, to every pastor. Truly,
a man that loves the Lord, and I know Shady Grove, you love God and you love your pastor, and I just appreciate the love we feel when we come here. You got your Bibles and you want to read along with us, we'll be reading out of the book of Colossians, the first chapter, and you pray for us today that we might do and say just exactly what God would have us to say. You pray from the depths of your heart, but before we go further, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Brother Rule Martin, will you lead us in the word while we pray?
Father, we find ourselves assembled with our people once again. Lord, we come holding up the man of the hour. You know, Lord, we love this young man from the very first time I ever hear him break the bread of life. And our Father, Lord, that soul made you give him, God, a preacher's wife. We thank you for that. Lord, now when we come down now to the hour, Lord, I pray that you'd bless your word. Lord, your inspired word. Lord, I pray that we lift him up, Lord, even to the third heaven. Let him walk around, Lord, and bring that from a far country. Father, we've got a lot of sickness on our hearts and minds and people, prayer requests, but thank you being so big that, Lord, we can bring everyone all over the world to you, and you can look and answer them in a moment. Why, it's a small matter for you, Lord, to, Lord, look down and see the souls of little boys and girls, men and women, that are lost, Lord, and send the gospel. Wherever that those needs are, and Lord, let it do its work. Oh, God, be with this man today. We need, God, I need, I'm standing in need today to be fed, Lord, from thy word. Lord, feed the church. Oh, God, bless God. And Lisa and Trevor and Nathan, Lord, be with them in a special kind of way. And their Father now, just revelate him now. Let him speak with wisdom, tongue, and utterance. Lord, that he'll be amazed when he leaves this place.
Yeah.
Lord, he say to church, lifting me high, lifting me up above the perishable thing of this world. And oh God, may the church get her mind upon heaven and divine things. God, today the things that are so important. So go with us now and bless our deacon board. Bless our church, piano player, and organist. Oh God, be with them now and go with them. Be with them at church camp. Lord, how much fun can you have it at church camp? Lord, they'll just bring back treasures of memories. Lord, let them have new things. Lord, if Scott gets to go, Lord, reveal to them the thing. Lord, keep him safe, but let them pull him on it. It'll just make him get closer to them. Yeah. So go with us and help us and bless as only you can in Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Rule, for that good prayer. Book of Colossians, the first chapter. And you pray for us today. Seems like we realize now more than ever the seriousness and the place where we stand. We try to declare unto you the truth of God's word. I say this, it's a privilege and an honor to be able to stand here and to try to tell somebody about Jesus. I thank God for every opportunity that we do have. I'm so thankful for it, but where the fear comes in is that if we say something wrong that would ever lead somebody in a wrong path, and that's never our desire. But we're a man and we're fleshly and we can make mistakes, and I'll assure you today, if I say something ever out of the way, if you come to me, I'll make acknowledgments and I'll apologize and I'll repent of it. But it's my desire to try to help God's people. My desire to try to be a help. I believe that's all our desires. As the church of the living God is to help each other, bear one another's burdens, to be a strength.
Preach.
And our desire as the church, I also believe we got something that's so wonderful and so good that time. We want to change our communities, and not that we're any better than anybody else, but rather we got the best thing that this world has to offer. And that's Christ Jesus living in us and among us. Mm-hmm. And so I want our communities, I want our county and our country to turn back to God. I want little boys and girls that's young and tender to believe on the name of Jesus before the world makes them hard and callous. But I'm glad today that we serve a God that's as strong and the Word is so powerful. That even though a man be old and I've seen things in this world and his heart has become hardened, I'm glad that the Bible says His Word is sharper than any two-edged sword. It can pierce a heart and change it for God. We want to know what it means to in this world to change lives. It's still the same thing, and it's Jesus Christ. He'll crucified and a risen Savior. It'll work. It'll change lives. It'll make a difference in our homes. It'll make a difference in our communities today. Need not to depend on our government, but depend on the Lord and see what God can do. And I believe He will change and work. The book of Colossians, the first chapter in verse 4, and I'm reading several verses. It says, "Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love which ye have to all the saints, for the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof ye heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel, which has come unto you as it is in all the world, and bringeth forth fruit as it doth also in you since the day ye heard it, and knew the grace of God in truth. As ye also learned of Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is for you a faithful minister of Christ, who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to desire that you might be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that ye might walk worthy of the Lord and all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might according to His glorious power, unto all patience and long-suffering with joyfulness, giving thanks unto the Father which hath made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light." Now listen to this verse. "Who hath delivered us from the power of darkness, and hath translated us into the kingdom of His dear Son, in whom we have redemption through His blood, even the forgiveness of sins." Who hath delivered us from the power of darkness? Well, I'm glad that God is a deliverer, ain't you?
Yeah, yes.
I'm glad God changes lives, and I'm glad God can take people and communities and deliver them from the power of darkness. Paul, a man of God that wrote, we know most of the New Testament, the majority of it, here was writing to a church that he didn't establish, to a people that he'd never even seen. I believe that to be the case. And but there's a preacher, I don't know if Paul sent him or not, but he, Epaphras, if that's the way you pronounce his name, and he went to the community, I guess you'd say, of Colossia, the Colossians, and there he began to preach and to teach what he had heard, maybe from the Apostle Paul and the other apostles. And Colossia was a place where they served many gods and had many different ways, and maybe even that day seemed like was the popular way to live, and maybe the only way they knew to live. They held up many gods and worshiped many different ones, but when here comes this little preacher, and he begins to tell about this man named Jesus, and no doubt when that he heard that he was a God, that the Colossians heard that Jesus was God, maybe they thought they would prop him up and make him just as all the other gods. But soon did they realize that Jesus said that even when he was here on the earth, he said, "I am the way." He wasn't just another God. And I'm afraid today there is a lot of people, and even a lot of churches that want to have Jesus as just anyway, and they want maybe to take the little of him, the good things, and but I'll say this today, all everything about Jesus is good. There ain't nothing about him that's bad. I want all of him. I don't want just part of him, for he is good, everything about him. And I know today that some of his teachings may be contrary to our nature, and we within ourselves can't understand that how to live a Christian life within us. I realize it's a hard way to live sometimes, but let's just be honest, it's hard to be good to those that hate you, ain't it? It ain't never been easy for me to somebody to speak up and talk to me like I'm just a nobody and nothing. It's hard for me to love those, but I'm reminded when Jesus said, "Why, you have heard it said, love your neighbor and hate your enemy." But Jesus said, not so. He said, love your enemies and pray for those which despitefully use you. Why, if I know anything today, why, I like what the Bible says. Why, it says, love will never fail. And today they say, I'm talking about biblical love, godly love. Why, it's impossible really to know what love is without knowing who God is. For the Bible said that God is love. And today, listen, I want us all to let the society has come and they've stolen that word. And they try to redefine it where if we love them, listen, they make it subjective. You can love and do whatever you want to, and everything will be all right. But I'm going to tell you today why fleshly love and a lust for the world, why, you know what it'll do? It'll bring destruction and heartache. And also, if you don't get right with God, it'll bring damnation, an eternal separation from God. But I'm glad that God so loved the world that while we were yet sinners, Christ Jesus died for the ungodly, ain't you? So that's the message, I believe, that old preacher came preaching. People that was rambunctious and wild, drunkenness and sexual immorality running wild. Listen, the lives they was doing and what they seen everybody else do, and no doubt they was living up. Listen, homes, husbands, you know what they done. They had a lot of power in that day. Listen, they treat their wives terrible and put them away for no reason. They beat their children with a rod and many stripes. But all today, listen, I'm glad when God gets in the midst of a home. Listen, God can make all the difference. And today I'll tell you what to do, it's all good. Brother, that's the church of the living God. And a lot of times, listen, it bothers me, you know, that 50% of marriages that established in a Baptist church, you know where they end at. Brother, they don't end at the grave, but they end in divorce court. And listen, it does all good today. To love our wives and love our spouses. And I'll say this today, the Bible said, husbands, love your wives. Lay up for your children. Children, not lay up for the fathers. And I'm telling you today, what we need in a world that seemingly cold and indifferent is men that'll get on their knees and become a servant, lift their bride up and love them. And it'll change the home. The Bible tells us that the men are to be the leaders of the home. And with leadership comes great responsibility. And it ain't about lording over our wives. Brother, it's about loving them, lifting them up, that they might shine and prosper, that they might be all that God wants them to be. And I'll say this today, when we husbands do that, brother, it'll make the wife fall in love.
I with a husband and I, and she'll want to be with him wherever he goes. How do you know that, preacher? Why? Because I believe this, that the church is called to be the bride of Christ. And if I know anything at all, Brother Darbroom, you know what he done. Brother laid down his life for you and I. That makes up the bride, the body. Brother, he loved us while we were in sinners. I thank God he died for us. And that's the reason, you know why he does. Brother, he wants every one of us in our life. He's not to beat us down or hold us back. But what he wants you and I to do, not only on an individual basis, but a corporate basis as a church, is to shine and prosper. Why he said, you are the light of the world. Brother, he wants our lives. And thank God today because he first loved me. That's why I love him. That's why I get up every day thanking God Almighty. Everything I've got comes from the Father above. Thank God today we serve a good God. Not only this today, that's what the world needs to hear. Even though they may have sinned and come short of the glory of God, hey, we need not to lord over them, make them feel inferior, make them feel backwards, but we're to go with tenderness, love in our heart, and let them know that nobody, all has sinned and come short of the glory of God. Better tell them it don't matter where they've been. There's a God that died for them. And brother, that God can change their lives today. I'm glad that I serve a life-changing God. I'm glad I serve a God that's able to take a father that abuses his children. Brother, to make that heart changing him into a loving daddy. I'm glad today I serve a God that can take an alcoholic mother and make her want to lay the bottle down, pick up her children and love them. Thank God today that's what we are as the church. We've got good news to tell a lost and a dying world that God is real, God is true, and he is a changer of lives today. That we have been translated, we all walk in the kingdom of darkness, but now we have been translated into the kingdom of light. Thank God the power of darkness. As the Bible said, in one place Paul said, well now, sin hath no more dominion of you. Hey, how do we want to change lives today? Let people know that if they'll believe in a crucified and a risen Savior, they don't have, hey, did you know this? Hey, brother, you don't have to be in bondage to a lying tongue. You don't have to be in bondage to gossip. You don't have to be in bondage to any sin. Hey, somebody said, well, alcoholics, hey, there ain't nothing that can change them. Hey, let's send them down to AA. I'll tell you where we ought to take them to. Brother, first place is the very first place we ought to take them to. Brother, it's the throne of grace. Jesus, Paul said, he said, come boldly to the throne of grace that you might obtain mercy and grace in your time of need. If I know anything at all, we're living in a world that's in a time of need. And that's what we ought to do. Jesus said, love your enemies. Pray for them. I wish to spitefully use you. You got somebody that hates you. Hey, get down on your knees and pray for them. See if it won't make a difference. And they called good news of a people he never seen, a church he didn't establish. But you know what Paul said. He said, from the time I've heard of the report that I've got, he said, I've not failed to make mention of your name in prayer. He said, I'm rejoicing that your lives have been changed, that you're not what you used to be. Hey, thank God today. Hey, they was sinners, but now they saints. Hey, they was without hope, but now
their hope had been laid up for them in heaven. I'm glad today God can give whatever we need. He can be that for us. We find in God's Word a community lesson that was full of paganism, serving all kind of gods. I'm sure it was like this. No doubt they were probably afraid to send their children. Fathers were probably afraid to send their young daughters out. Afraid they might not come home. Might get raped, beat up. Today, no, there's no all kind of things was going on in that culture. You say, what does that have to do with us? We've been, ain't that what a secular society tells us? We've evolved. We've learned and we've advanced in things. But if I know anything at all, brother, when I look out into our world, do you think evil exists? I tell you what you do. Go home and turn on the 6 o'clock news. And that's all you'll hear about is every kind of evil under the sun. And today I don't listen. You may be here today and say, I don't think it's really that bad. Let me ask you this question. Do you lock your doors at night? Do you lock your doors when you leave to come to church? Hey, I'm telling you today, it's sad when you can't even have assurance that your home, like leaving your home without having to be worried about it being broken and stolen. Hey, when I was a little boy growing up, you know what we kids would do? We'd go outside, we'd play all day long. Mom and daddy didn't have to worry about us children. We knew our neighbors was. We didn't have to worry about being kidnapped, sold into sledge traffic, all those things. But now I'm telling you, it ain't just down in Atlanta, Georgia. Brother, it's creeped up into Forsyth County, Georgia today. Satan is going by like a roaring lion, walking up and down Brother Shady Grove Road. He's making laps, and you know what he's doing. He's looking and trying to devour our children. And he's trying his very best to destroy homes. But I'm glad today the Bible was said where sin did abound, grace did much more abound. I tell you today, the problem of evil is still sure. It's still real. But if I'm glad there's hope today that Jesus is Lord as he's on the throne. Thank God he can get in the midst of a people. He can take a kidnapper, brother, to change the hearts. Do you think that's a problem? Amen. I think it's a problem today. And I still believe that God is the answer. God is the solution that can change lives. Stop depending on the government and depend on God. And we'll be amazed at what can happen. God ain't lost one bit of his power, has he? He said, I'm the same today, yesterday, forevermore. He said, I'm God and I change not. You know what God wants to be in our life? Brother, he don't want to be second place. Brother, he wants to be first place, doesn't he? Hey, today, listen, I believe this today. There ain't none of us perfect in this life, nor will we ever be perfect. But we've been called to live. We've been called to grow. We've been called to give God's Word down. Let me say this today. If the only Word of the Lord you're getting is on Sunday morning between 11 and 12 o'clock, you're missing a whole lot today. I'm telling you, we're supposed to grow into the image of Christ. They call it sanctification, being transformed. The more we live here on this earth, to be transformed, to look more like Christ looked. Let our speech be seasoned with salt. Let our lives be light and not darkness. And how are we going to do that? Hey, brother, I tell you today, it's getting God's holy word down and getting into it and asking God to give us. I'm glad that every answer to every problem of life. Thank God today I don't have to run to the government. But, brother, I can open my book and I can find the answer to whatever life's problem is in my life. It's contained between the lids of this book. Jesus said, I am. He is the Word. This is who he is. This is God. He said he was the Word. He is the Word. This is what everything that God knew. There's the Bible says there's nothing new under the sun. There's nothing that takes God by surprise. Nothing. and he's given us the answer to every problem that we'll face. Their government's not going to go along with it. I know Matt mentioned Wednesday night about going and talking, and I believe that. I believe, amen, let Christians stand up and be bold. If we don't stand up and speak the truth, brother, I tell you what it's going to do, be overtaken by a bunch of lies. Maybe that's what the Bible, you know what the Bible said that Satan was. He said he was a liar. He's the father of it. And I'll tell you this today, we can speak and proclaim. Hey, that's what you and I do. That's what I do when I stand up and proclaim God's word. Brother, it's proclaiming it. Why can I proclaim it? Because what my life is built on is not a farce. Hey, it's not a myth. It's not a fairy tale. But brother, it's built on the truth. It's built on the rock. It's built on a solid foundation. Hey, I tell you today, listen, that's the reason the gospel will stand. That's the reason when the world's on fire, everything else passes off and goes away. Brother, God's word will not return unto him. Boy, it will stand. You remember what happened on Gamaliel when the apostles began to preach the word? There's a group of Pharisees, religious leaders, got up, said, well, what we need to do is silence these boys. We need to stop them from speaking and preaching Jesus. You know why they was doing that? Because, hey, the Bible said those ignorant, unlearned men, 12 of them, Bible said they turned the world upside down. Hey, the religious powers of that day, hey, the government authorities, you know what was happening to them? The 12 men believed what Jesus told them to preach and teach, and it was changing lives. People realized they didn't have to believe the lie of the devil. They began to preach and teach it. And the men got together and said, we need to put a stop to this thing. There's an old Pharisee, a very intelligent man named Gamaliel. He said, you better leave him alone. He said, if it's of not of God, it'll fall. But he said, if it's of God, there's nothing we can do to stop it from going any further. I want to assure you today, when you stand up and testify, when you stand up on God's word today, even all the host of hell comes against you, brethren, you can sure be assured that God's word will stand in what you're speaking. Be bold in it. Be very brave. Be very courageous. God's word will stand. You've got truth on your side. We've got truth on our side. We've got answers to all the problems of life today. And we're the only ones that do, as far as that matters goes. You and I that's been saved and believed in this book, we've got truth on our side. We've got truth. How do you know that? I've seen it. I've experienced it. I've witnessed it. And I've been a part of it. It's you. God has miraculously and wondrously, wonderfully changed my life. Thank God. Oh, wretched man that I am, Paul said. Oh, wretched man. Paul used to be a wretched man, didn't he? You know what Paul did every place he went? Every time he began to stand up and talk, began to share his experience about what happened to him on a Damascus Road. Boy, I'm glad I got a Damascus Road experience, ain't you? Boy, I'm glad I became a tender with a life-changing God. And I'm glad he took my life and changed it for the good. And I'm glad today my life is not what it could have been. Hey, today, you know what it does? That's the reason it breaks my heart today. I look at people, a lot of people are judgmental. They look out on society, they want to cast stones, and they want to, you know what stones do? Remember this, before the next time we throw a stone, you know what stones do? Stones hurt, don't they? Stones leave bruises. Stones ain't very, you've been ever hit with a stone, it don't feel good. Hey, today I've been hit with them, they do not feel good today. But I'm glad today when some old grayhead saint of God will come down and put their arms around me, wrap their loving arms around me, begin to whisper, tell me there's a God in heaven that loved me. Brother, that made all the difference in my life. God can make a difference.
Yes.
God works through every one of us. The Bible teaches that we are God's temple. We are God's people. We are what the light shines in, ain't we? We are where Jehovah, the glory of God, that's where he abides in all of us, individuals, But the Bible teaches, as I believe it is in the book of Ephesians, that we are lively stones that have been shapen together to be made into the temple of God. When the church comes together, a community of believers comes together, God's presence begins to shine, begins to abide in that people. In the old temple, on the Day of Atonement, when a high priest would go into the Holy of Holies, and he'd lay down the sacrifice on it between the cherubims on the mercy seat of the Ark of the Covenant, God Almighty would come down in a cloud of smoke and fill the temple, and all the people would look at it and see it. But you know what? The next day they'd wake up and that'd be gone. But now you and I are the temple of the living God.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, our high priest, went in one time and offered his life as a sacrifice, his blood, one time, but has now forever set down the right hand of the Father. And you and I can go in the Holy of Holies, ever God's glory comes down and it abides. You know what? When we get up in the morning, it ain't gone, is it? It is still in us every single day, in where? In our hearts, in our souls. The glory of God, Jehovah God, He abides here, and He changes life. Oh, today, listen, we got a great work to do. There's people that need us. There's people that hate us. There's people that don't want no part of us. But you know what we can do? We can love them like Jesus loved them, can't we? That's what we've been commissioned to do, is to pray for them. Jesus said, go out. Start in Jerusalem. Samaria. When you get to Samaria, don't stop there. When you get to wait to Jerusalem until he endured for power on high and preach the word. But don't stop there. He said, then go down to Samaria and preach the word. But when you get down to Samaria, don't stop at Samaria. He said, but just go into all the uttermost parts of the world. He said, I've equipped you. I'm giving you everything that you need. Go out into all the world preaching his gospel. One of my favorite verses in all the Bible is it says, where the word of the king is, there is power. You see, why I can believe I got power on my side is because it's not my word that I'm preaching, but it's the power, it's the word of the king, our king, the Lord Jesus Christ. His word has got power in it. And I preach and declare unto you his word. You got problems in your home, you get God in the midst of it. You offer your family Jesus and see if it can make a difference.
Amen.
Problems in our school system, let's go down there with the love of God in our hearts and tell them that God loves them, and give them the truth and stand on it and see if it won't make a difference. Hey, we may get stoned, we may get cussed at, we may get hollered at. Jesus didn't tell us everybody would love us, did he? He just said, you go. See, we need not depend on results. If we get results-based oriented, we might be disappointed. He just said, you go, you do what I tell you to do, and I'll take care of the rest. That's all we're required to do. So whether I stand and preach and there's hundreds of thousands get saved, to God be the glory. But I'll tell you this today, if I stand Sunday after Sunday and nobody ever walks out, I will have lived a life worth living. Rule every mile you travel to the hospital, every bed you visit, somebody's sick. Don't believe you do it all. I don't believe you change a thing. Every person we've seen that's been in need of somebody just stopping by and seeing them and talking to them and showing them love, it makes a difference in the lives of this world. That's what we need. That's what I need. Boy, I need to be changed. There's a lot of changes I need to make in my life. And I can't do it on my own. What I need is the power of an almighty God to change me and to keep molding me and shaping me in what he wants me to be. And I'll say this today. When we get there as a church, as a corporate people, as individuals, let God really begin to work. And we really begin to believe. Do you really believe God is who he says he is? Do we really believe that? When we really get to that place, then I believe this. Things will begin to really take place and shape it up. And I'll say this. People will know there is something different about us in our community. Come get you a soul. If you're here today and never been saved by God's grace, you can come and be saved. If you got problems in your life, hey, don't be ashamed. Everybody's got problems. Listen, I don't care. Everybody's got problems. Everybody does. If we need to come pray, you come pray. Jesus said, my house shall be called a house of prayer, didn't he? My house. You know what he told me? He said, you turn it into the den of thieves. Listen, don't let Satan rob you of getting coming to the throne of grace boldly. We are to be praying and lifting Jesus up every single time the doors of the church is open. Praying and asking him to equip us and endure us and give us what we need. Hey, pray for our children going back into school. They're facing things now that you and I probably have no idea what they're going through. And I'll tell you what my prayer is for you young people going back to school. Listen, I know you're going to be faced with peer pressure. And I know you're going to be faced with opposition. Your students may laugh at you and poke at you and talk down about you about being a Christian. But I'll assure you this today. When I was in high school, listen, I had a bunch of friends. That's been 1993, the year I graduated. But you know what? A lot of my friends have gone and I ain't seen them in a long time. But there's one friend that's been with me every step of the way. It's never disappointed me. And that is, if I could go back, I don't want you to be like me. Say, if I could go back and do it all over again, I'd do it differently. I've got a lot of regrets about the way I treated people. I do. I can't go back. I can't do it over. Oh, I wished I'd been closer to Jesus all my life, don't you? Don't find yourself 20-something years later saying, I wished I'd have done it different. When it's hard, that's when it's worth. That's when it's hard. When they talk about you, when they look at you and laugh at you for standing true to what you believe in, and they say, well, that's backwards. That's from the 1950s. I tell you what you do. You tell them it goes way further back than 1950s. It goes back in the beginning, and we serve a Creator that loves everybody. And you stand firm to Him, and He'll stand firm to you. I'll tell you this, you stand up for Jesus, He'll stand up for you. So while we stand the same, you follow the Lord this morning. Page 534. He said that was he'd go to places that was full of wretched people, sinful lifestyles. He began to preach and share the views of Jesus. And all of a sudden, people that once were selfish, drunkards, didn't like one another, all of a sudden they become good, worldly, godly people. Just for a moment in time, all things was made right in some life. Ain't that good? Ain't that good when you're able to see it we've all been in church services before where everything was just forgot about. Where sister so-and-so forgot about their dislike for brother so-and-so. All that stuff was gone out. God's spirit came down, and just for a minute, wrong relationships was made right. There was nothing but love and peace. I believe that's what Paul was saying. I have sat in heavenly places from time to time at you when God's people just loved everybody. And when Paul seen the community he preached begin to be transformed and changed, those people that once was bull and vulgar, now all of a sudden they loved each other and had a love for God. I believe that's what he was saying. And I tell you this today, that's what can happen to you and I. We can sit in heavenly places and see God's kingdom become a reality here on earth. God bless you this morning is my prayer. So, if there's nothing else, we go further. All right, you may be seated. Today is your regular scheduled conference. And before we go into conference, Brother Matt Martin, would you lead us in a word of prayer?
Kind and gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for allowing us to assemble ourselves here today. Father, as we are, Lord, we thank you for Brother Shannon, Lord, bringing him as wife here today with us, Lord, and Lord, thank you for the message that he has brought today. Lord, let us apply that to our lives, Father, as we go forward. Lord, we pray that we just be a light for some lost soul, Lord, be saved. Lord, again, just go with us through this conference, Lord. Let your will be done. Lord, we just want to uplift your name. Father, we just want to be a light on the hill for you. Lord, we just thank you again for all you've blessed us with. Be with the ones that aren't able to be here. But Lord, we just most of all thank you for sending your son, Jesus Christ, die on the cross. Lord, for our sins. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You may not consider yourself in conference. First item of business.
Need a break from my record.
Oh, you got it. Okay. Make a blurry. Okay. Oh, sorry.
From Mark. Well, I nominate Brother Shannon Westbrook being our moderator.
Second.
All in favor.
I think I got it for yours.
We'll get there together. We'll cross the finish line together. We'll get it. Y'all help me. First item of business, you may consider yourself in conference. So the first item of business is about visiting members to sit with us. And certainly Shady Grove thanks the good Lord for every visitor that they have. And your help needed when called upon. Thank the Lord for y'all. Second item, call for any volunteer acknowledgments. None offered. Third item, references. Do you have any references? No references. All right. Fourth item is open the doors of the church. We'll do this under three headings. If you're here today, the Lord has saved your soul and you'd like to come as a candidate for baptism, we invite you to do that. You have your letter with you from the sister church in St. Faith and Order. Like to come and put a deposit with the clerk. We advise you to do that, or if you like to come and join in the watch chair until your letter can be obtained from the sister church of the St. Faith and Order. We invite you to do that also. So while we stand and sing a verse of some song, the doors of Shady Grove Baptist Church.
Page 479.
I once was
peace and fellowship. Gospel steps been taken. Satisfaction not been reached. You now. Peace and fellowship. But if you're in peace and fellowship, the church will be known by rising your hand. Is that the way we do it? I'm sorry. May record the church in peace.
Amen.
This is the third one I've done, and everybody's done it different. So I forget where I'm at sometimes, so y'all forgive me. Sixth item is general business. Any general business?
From the moderator, I make a motion that voting by secret ballot be suspended and voting by acclamation be used.
Got a move and second that you suspend voting by secret ballot and vote by acclamation. All in favor of this, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same sign. Ayes have it. Motion is carried.
Brother moderator, this preacher calling time. The deacon board makes a move that Brother Scott Sorrell will be our pastor for the coming year.
Got a move and second that Brother Scott Sorrells will be your pastor for the upcoming year. All in favor of this, let it be known by rising to your feet. You may be seated. Thank the Lord for this.
It's time to elect the rest of the officers, and I make a motion that we keep the same ones for the ensuing year.
Got a move and a second that you keep the same officers for the upcoming year. All in favor of this, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same sign. Ayes have it. Motion is carried. You got the same officers.
Brother Monterey, we need to like one more thing. Our High Tower Association meeting is coming up. We need to let two delegates come with the pastor. He's so desired. But we need to let those two officers today. If it's okay, I'd like to nominate one. They can nominate whoever. I'll nominate one at Mike Smith.
Miles McGovern.
Okay. Any other general business? You read the minutes
there? Yeah. Okay.
All right, President.
Sunday, August 15th, 2021. Shady Grove Baptist Church, after preaching by Reverend Shannon Westbrook in a prayer, conference was called for. First item was to invite distant members to seat with us. Second item was called for volunteer acknowledgments. There were none. Third item was called for references. There were none. Fourth item was open the doors of the church. None joined. Fifth item was call for peace and fellowship with the church, reported in peace. Sixth item is general business. It was a motion that voting by secret ballot be suspended and vote by acclamation. With a movement and second and a verbal vote, motion passed. There was a motion that Reverend Scott Sorrells be pastor for the upcoming year with a movement and second and a standing vote, motion passed. There was a motion that all officers remain for the upcoming year with a move and a second and a verbal vote, motion passed. Delegates for the upcoming year are Mike Smith and Miles McGovern. There being no further business, conference is adjourned in order. Reverend Shannon Westbrook, moderator pro tem, Miles McGovern, church clerk.
So we have a conference then? You need to read. You need to adopt the amendments?
Yeah, adopt it with read.
Yeah, move in a second.
You can move in a second on that.
All right.
Well, no.
You can move in a second.
No.
Doctor
is red.
All right. Doctor is red. Okay. Yep. We got it. Now you may consider yourself that time. Let's get out of this thing while we're here. All right. All right. Nothing next. All right. Y'all remember now, go home. get on that YouTube channel, like that. Ask God to give us a whole bunch of likes. All right, if there's nothing else, stand at your feet, shake hands, woman.